You haven't watched Coco yet? The Disney movie that literally made everyone cry. Heyo, this is Leah with an H, and today it is Halloween, so I am going to talk about El Dia de los Muertos, because in the Philippines, we have exactly the same traditions that the movie Coco portrays. And if you haven't watched Coco yet, just watch it right after this video. Spoiler alert, story time. Coco is a movie that takes place in Mexico. It follows the story of Miguel, a young boy that is passionate about music. He cannot stop playing guitar. He sings every time. Disney movies. His dream is to become a musician. Yes, un artista. Like Ernesto de la Cruz, who is his idol. But his very traditional family has banned music forever, but we don't know why. This is supposed to be like fading. Okay, never mind. No props! But Miguel broke the rule! Miguel is so stubborn. He's a rebel. He's like super matigas ng ulo. He went to the cemetery and he stole the guitar of his idol Ernesto de la Cruz. What? And he accidentally entered the land of the dead. Do you want that, kids? Never steal something from the others, or you will end up in the land of the dead. Mm-hmm. So now, the Philippines and Coco. FYI, the Philippines were colonized by Spanish people. That is why there's so many influences from Spain. In the language, coche, cuchara, diciembre, febrero, ocho ocho. In the architecture, religion, names, Jose, Gonzalez, Luis, Luisa, the food, and traditions. On October 31st and November 1st, those 2 days are declared as non-working days. But actually, this holiday has so many different names. El Dia de los Muertos, Undas, Araw ng Mga Patay, the Day of the Dead, the Sacred Day of the Dead, All Saints Day, La Toussaint. So during those 2 days, Filipino families come visit their loved ones in the cemetery. Wait. It's not like in the American movies where you see everyone wearing black. It's so quiet and calm and super depressing. Nah, it has nothing to do with that. The cemeteries turn into huge camping grounds. You see tents everywhere around the graves, and it becomes a huge fiesta with food, music everywhere. And yes, you heard it. Food is back. It's so funny because every time I make a video about Filipino stuff, there's food involved. There is an old tradition. It's called pag-aatang. So you're offering food to the people who passed away. The first time I witnessed that, I'm not gonna lie, I was very, very shocked. And for me, it was very disrespectful for the dead. I mean, you're eating on their graves. Huh? I was very young and I asked my dad, Papa, c'est bizarre. C'est bizarre quand même qu'il s'assoit sur la tombe quand même. Qu'il s'allonge et qu'il mange. And my dad was like, non, c'est pas bizarre. You're actually sharing your food and spending time with the people who passed away. It's just as if they were with you. And that changed everything. I completely changed my way of seeing things. So at the end, it's a holiday that really calls for a big family reunion. For me, it's even bigger than Christmas because in Undas, you are reuniting with the people who are alive and dead. So Coco is a Disney movie, and obviously, just like any other Disney movies, there are life lessons. What I've learned is that family and traditions are very sacred and important, but it's also important to follow your dreams. If those dreams are against some traditions, I believe that if your family really, really loves you, they will support you no matter what. They will find a way, especially if you prove them that you strongly believe in your dreams. I hope that you enjoyed this video, but it was very important for me to share my cultures, and I hope it will really open your mind and be curious to watch Coco. If you liked it, just put a like. Merci, salamat, shukran, thank you. Muchas gracias. Y a bientôt.